Hello everyone, welcome to our ninth week of Pacific Music Works online season. This week we are presenting our performance of Handel's Semele from March 16, 2014 at Meany Hall in collaboration with the University of Washington School of Music. Handel was certainly the greatest musical dramatist between Monteverdi and Mozart. From the time he wrote his first opera, Almira, in Hamburg at the age of 19, until his death, his life and career were devoted to music's power to heighten the impact of drama. First through opera itself, and for the last 25 years of his life, through his invention of the English oratorio. Our modern perception of Handel, particularly in America, is so dominated by the omnipresence of the Messiah that it is only in the past 50 years or so, and aided by the early music revival during the same period, that we have begun to perform some of his more than 40 Italian operas. Handel wrote his first large-scale English oratorio, Esther, in 1732, and his last Italian opera, Dei Damia, in 1741. Although Handel, the musical dramatist, excelled in both forms, the oratorio was significantly different in being performed in a concert hall without action rather than a theater, being in English rather than Italian, using largely religious themes rather than secular, and most significant structurally by the inclusion of large amounts of music for chorus. At the height of his career in oratorio in 1742, he created The Messiah on a biblically derived text devised by Charles Jennings. When, in the following season, Handel turned to an opera libretto by William Congreve, written in 1707 as the basis for his newest oratorio on the story of Semele, Jennings dismissed it as unworthy subject and a bawdy entertainment. Despite the upright moral of the story, a cautionary tale against overweening ambition and sexual license, there seems to have been just too much treachery, jealousy, sex, and fun before getting to the moral for the straight-laced and pious segment of the oratorio crowd. Regardless of its reception at the time, the artistic result for us is the lone example of an English opera from the latter part of Handel's career. The chamber opera, Acis and Galatea, written for private performance in 1718, is the only other one at all. There's a small irony in the fact that Messiah's overwhelming popularity in this country is partly because it is in English, whereas our Italian-centered institution of the Opera House is far more likely to produce one of his Italian operas rather than Semele. It is also a special effort to mount because of the large amount of choral music to be memorized for the stage. But as an artistic artifact, Semele is certainly a grand Handelian masterpiece to set beside the Messiah, almost a secular sister work to that piece. And performed with the right combination of imagination, skill, and inspiration, it may well enter into the mainstream of beloved operatic masterpieces. This production was the first in a series of large-scale experiments at the University of Washington, including student choristers and orchestral students teamed desk for desk with the professional orchestral musicians of Pacific Music Works. The stage direction was by James Darrah, with projections designed by Adam Larson, costume design by Sarah Schussler, and lighting design by Cameron Mock. The cast was Heron Hong as Semele, Aaron Sheehan, Jupiter, Nathan Medley, Athamas, Peabody Southwell, Juno and Ino, Colin Ramsey, Cadmus and Somnus, and Valerie Vincent as Iris. In part one, Semele is set to marry Prince Athamas, but she is secretly in love with Jupiter, king of the gods. Jupiter sends thunder to disrupt the ceremony and then abducts Semele to a palace in the realm of the gods. Juno, his wife, furious at her husband's adultery, sends her messenger Iris to discover the location of her rival. We hope you enjoy part one of Handel's Semele, and please push the button below to join our Pacific Music Works YouTube channel.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. cher Woody. Since you so kind, Flashes right. Juno, accept or sacrifice. Again, the sickly flame decaying dies. Juno, what angry Jove denies.
Cease, cease, you bounds, this is to see, begone, and die.
Unknown before, who could the hidden cause explore, or think that love could act so strange a part to plead for pity in a rival's heart? You wonder me, look not on me, wonder me, guilt of raving, shame in vain, guilt of raving, shame in vain. Look on me, move on me, move on me. With my life I would atone for the pain to me alone. Cease to shun me, look on me, move on me. Love alone has more than one. Love alone has more than one. You undone me, cease to shun me.
Johnny.
You and Danny.
With my life on wood at home.
Mother's moon has broken bone.
Cease to Johnny. Cease to Johnny.
You and Danny.
Cease to Johnny.
When Semele, around her head with azure flames was graced, whose lambent glories in her tresses played. All this we saw with dread surprise, swifter than lightning downward, tending an eagle stooped, a mighty size on purple wings descending. Like gold his beak, like stars shone forth his eyes, his silver plumy breast with snow contending. Suddenly snatched the trembling maid, soaring from our sight unveiled, diffusing ever celestial blue. Celestial.